Welcome to a Champions League semi-final. Leg one against Liverpool at home to start, followed by Leeds in the Premier League, and then the second leg against Liverpool midweek, before, of course, we end the Premier League season tomorrow. A Premier League season that, remarkably, we're still in the fight for the title in. It's still highly unlikely, but teams around us, or above us, most crucially, have been dropping points. We've gone from 13 points off top to 5 points off top with 4 games to go. It's doable. As such, playing this, that's the state of my starting 11, playing this game against Liverpool with that team, in fact, I can take Nibs out and put Nemecha back into the starting lineup, with that team to give ourselves the best possible chance of beating Leeds to stay in the hunt for the Premier League. We've won the Champions League already. Yes, it would be great to win it again, but I want to win the Premier League, so I'm giving that my utmost attention. Drop the video a like if you enjoy. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on the end of this season, and let's go and see if we can get through against Liverpool as well. Liverpool's 11, Alisson, Virgil van Dijk still captain and leading the line at the back with Hoover alongside him. Who have they got in the rest of their starting 11? Gabriel Jesus at centre forward in a 4-3-3 with a false 9. Dembele and Vallejo on the left-hand side. Harry Kane in midfield. That's an odd... And which Vallejo is that as well? It's an odd 11 from Liverpool. Alisson in goal. Klosterman, Van Dijk, Hoover and Andy Robertson. That makes sense. Nicolo Barella, Bruno Fernandes. And oh, it's Herbie Kane. Herbie Kane in midfield. Gabi Jesus, Karamoko Dembele and Manu Vallejo. Herbie Kane in midfield, not Harry. My mistake. I apologise. I swear I've made that mistake before in previous series, in previous years as well. But we are fielding a team that should be able to compete here against Liverpool. It's a team filled of players that have competed at Premier League level and been relatively decent at Premier League level as well. And with Liverpool having some ageing stars like Andy Robertson, like Virgil, they are going to be vulnerable at times, and having players like Herbie Kane in there who, with all due respect, he's not going to be one of the best midfielders in world football right now. Bruno Fernandes is playing in a defensive midfield position with Nicolo Barella alongside he and Herbie, but Manu Vallejo and Gabi Jesus, what's Bruno Fernandes pushing forward, could still cause us a number of problems at the back. Skip's trying his best to get that off Klosterman, but he can't. Swear Vieira's offside, he was. They hit the post in the opening 10 minutes, Liverpool, and looked dangerous, but we've survived. Pereira Rock will get that forward to Nemecha. And Bissouma will find Brian Son on this occasion, who's gone for the 1-2, and Hoover makes a brilliant interception to deny Brian Son the opportunity to race him behind and give us a 1-0 lead. We've been rather fortunate in that I think every double-legged knockout stage Champions League tie we've played over the course of 2 seasons has been at home in the first leg every single time. So we've been able to try and get a solid home leg result before then going away from home and knowing exactly what we have to do away goal-wise to ensure that we're the ones that kind of throw the spanner in the works with an away goal rather than an away side come to us in the second leg and score a late away goal, leaving us needing multiple more goals. Stefan holds on to that nicely. I do prefer to play the home leg first and then the second leg away. And we've been very fortunate that it has been my preference every single time so far. Can Brian Song get to that ahead of Van Dijk? Yeah, he can. And by a long way too. And he's gotten away from the next defender. Allison's there. And Nemecha follows up. Back in the starting lineup from injury. On the score sheet in the Champions League. Lucas Nemecha makes it Cambridge 1, Liverpool 0. Another very lucky, fortuitous rebound goal. We'll take them all. Bruno Fernandes pinging a superb ball out to Manu Vallejo, who's turned straight into Pereira Rock. Liverpool are struggling for fitness as well. Their team not as strong as it could be because of the nature of the fixture list right now. Another example of why having as many players as at the club as we do has been beneficial to us in the latter stages of a season. Try and turn that around the corner for Brian Son to run onto, and he's away here, and he's got more time and space this time, and Brian Son should finish this, and does. Cambridge 2, Liverpool 0. It might be a third string side, but it's still very effective. Jesus. Looking to get away. Skip wins it back. We're playing so well here. Kind of taking advantage of the fact that Liverpool are stretched. And Brianson, oh, doesn't score a third as Klosterman gets back. Oh, hopefully I don't end up ruining that missed opportunity. I was in again and I really should have finished that off. Not to worry, 2-0 up at half-time and going really well. Surprisingly well, but still really well. Liverpool are yet to have a shot. Yet to have a shot. Keep that up, please. Jesus to Klosterman. Maybe Jesus again. Inside to Herbie Kane. Nicolò Barella. Into Bruno Fernandes. I swear Harry Kane is at Liverpool as well. Manu Viejo's cross is blocked. I think they do have Harry Kane in their lineup or in their squad. I might be mistaken. He's definitely not at Tottenham anymore. I know he's moved somewhere in the Premier League. Jesus to Bruno Fernandes. Drops the shoulder well. He's got support. He's trying to go solo and then realised he couldn't do that. Here's Karamoko. Dembele. Klosterman bumped off it by Wilson. Legally so. Brianson get to that. Hoover intercepts nicely. Drawing their defenders well out of position though. So open at the back, Liverpool. Desperately open. If I can catch them on the counter, then we can score a third and put this tie beyond any reasonable doubt, let alone just this one leg. We can put the entire tie to bed. Nemecha looking to race away. Again, Brianson has gone. Oh, but I just can't find him. 22 minutes to play. I could make a couple of changes to try and freshen things up, but I think this side have been playing well enough themselves to warrant finishing the entire 90. I will perhaps bring someone like Palomino on for Bissouma just to add some fresh legs in the middle, but everyone else has been playing really well and deserves the opportunity to see the job through. Win that header, please. Well up, Pereira Rock, and Tyler Wright will get rid. And as far as Barella, though, back in. Tyler Wright tries again. And as far as Barella again, Bruno Fernandes back in. Tyler Wright away again. Oh, it was Chris Meppham on this occasion, and Barella knocks it down to Herbie Kane. Liverpool putting the pressure on, but they're still not shooting. And that's their problem. You can't score a goal if you don't shoot, at the risk of sounding like Michael Owen. Right, let's take Bissouma off and let's bring Palomino on. Yeah, go on then. We will bring... No, not Giovanni Reina. Let's bring Evans on. He's been very good for us in previous games. And Leon Davis can come on for Pereira Rock at right back as well. Let's crack on with 14 minutes to go. They're taking Van Dijk off at centre back. So defensive changes for Liverpool to try and ensure that they don't fall further behind. Oh, what a save by Stefan. Jesus keeps it in. Then away by Brianson. Another corner for them. They also brought on Nabil Fekir for Herbie Kane. So Liverpool making attacking changes as well as defensive changes. And here is Nabil Fekir on his favoured left foot. Bruno Fernandes whips a dangerous ball in first time, but Wright clears. And with 10 to go, we still feel pretty comfortable in this tie to Nemecha and Evans. How many times have we seen Dominic Evans do this in a Cambridge United shirt? And looking for Ethan Clark on the far side to finish it off. Alisson in the way. Alisson in the way. Another change for Liverpool. Brianson delivers the corner. Up goes Lucas Nemecha. Oh, dream header. Whoa. Rate that. Lucas Nemecha with his second of the game. We've been scoring a number of headers from corners recently. And that is one of the best of the bunch. What a header. Alisson, no chance. Cambridge 3, Liverpool 0. And that could be us into the final of the Champions League for the second season in a row before even having to play a second leg. It's the final whistle. A solid display. A convincing display. Very competent and calm and composed throughout. Liverpool with 3 chances on goal in the end. I think they all came in that one flurry where Gabi Jesus had a number of chances with corners aplenty for Liverpool during that phase of the game, but they weren't able to make anything pay. Couldn't get themselves an away goal. And we head to Leeds now, as everybody else has won, annoyingly, on match day 35. We can still be 5 points from top. Sorry, I forgot. We can still be 5 points off top if we win away from home against Leeds, but we do now need to win away from home against Leeds to ensure the title race continues. 12 points available for us, 9 points available for everyone else, but we need to make sure that we win this game. Otherwise, it is over with regards to the Premier League title. Let's go and beat Leeds United. Leeds 11, Elia Capriel in goal. Martinez, Losa, Liam Lindsay, Gunter and Campbell at the back. Alfie McCalmont sat holding with Serescu, Oliver, Bali Mumba and Ryan Simpson with Francisco Pizzini up top. Who the hell are most of those players? Are they regens? Are they players I've just not heard of from other teams? I'm not sure, but I mean, I don't jinx yourself, Chez. We'll try our best. They do have 3 or 4 regens in their starting lineup, Leeds. I did have a quick check. A number of them are real-life people, so to speak, but they're just players that I just haven't heard of, like Pizzini up top. Just not aware of who they are or where they play in real life. But at Season 9, you don't really tend to have that many original players at a club. Pizzini going for it there. It would have been a hell of a goal. After 10 minutes, first chance of the game goes Leeds United's way. With our full strength 11, we got to be winning this. And we got to be winning it well. Are you onside there? He's not quite Aberdeer. Play Jack rolls in, who certainly could have scored a banger. Just put it in the top bins, but it won't count because Aberdeer was offside. And to be fair, the keeper might well have saved it anyway. But a positive start for both sides, to be fair. Pizzini having an opportunity, although albeit not very well taken. Neither was that pass very well taken. We've had the ball in the back of the net, though. All we've got to do now is actually make it count. Serescu. Oh, get off. Brandon Williams says, I'll have that, thank you very much. Martinelli forced to go centrally. Oh, space for Campos. Please time this right, Chiz. He's in. David Campos was taking the extra time to get the angle to ensure that it was going to go in on the far side. I couldn't do it because the defender was back at me. Campos will get to that first, though. Actually give it to Cano in there. Then look for Jack Rolls, who's onside and hits the post. I'll be honest, I thought he was off. Brown's kept that in play really well. Can't find a man in the middle yet, so we'll just take our time. Let's not needlessly give the ball away. Martinelli. Oh, it will fall for Aberdeer, and we do lead, and that's a very good finish. A very good finish from a man who's still hunting the golden boot. Oh, it's so, again, I'm so lucky with the way that it's fallen free through the goal, the defender's legs. God, that was hard to say. Fallen free through the defender's legs, but accomplished finish. Talk about it. 23rd goal of the Premier League season for Agustin Aberdeer. We lead at Elland Road. Ping, I think is the word. Serescu brings it down nicely too. Back to, oh, it's really nicely done. Serescu. Back to Alfie McCalmont trying to pull the strings in that CDM role. Oh, no Calvin Phillips anymore. Only Alfie McCalmont. Oh, come on, Chiz. How many times do you do that and it costs you? Get out! Oh, I actually live to tell the tale on that occasion rather than giving the ball away like that and then conceding a goal. It was close. We've done it multiple times before and you guys have berated me for it multiple times before. Sander Berger has won that back and a counter is on. Oh, come on, Campos, make a run. Thankfully, Martinelli is lively on the left-hand side. Actually going to give this to Jack Rolls if we can. Touch away from the defender. Finish 2. Cambridge 2, Leeds 0. We're going to be winning. We're going to be closing the gap to the top again. Serescu with a throw. Can we get there with Martinelli? We can. Mistake from Leeds. Lift that. Please keep that in, or he will comfortably so. And takes in his stride well too. I just need to find... Oh, David Campos at the back post. Volimers, no, he's gone with his head. Jack, off the line. Brown, off the line again from Lindsay. Sander Berger, touch is dead and the chance is gone. What defending from Leeds United. Wow, well played. Very well played indeed. Lindsay, I think it was the same player off the line twice, once with a header, once with the shot block. That was incredible from Leeds. They want to stay in this game as long as they possibly can. Give themselves a chance in the second half of coming back into it. And Lindsay has given them that opportunity. They just need to actually now go and score some goals. Which hopefully they don't do. Out wide to Perez Seol. Through there to Don Brown. He's done brilliantly, actually, to step away. And Aberdeer is here. Oh, the little back heel. Jack Rolls to finish it off. 3-0 Cambridge. I nearly jinxed myself at the beginning of this game, where I was about to say, surely against a side like this, we should definitely be getting victory with the amount of unknown names that were in there. I held off, managed to not jinx myself. Lovely assist by Aberdeer. Great take and finish from Jack Rolls as well. His second of the game and his eighth of the Premier League season. We are winning in style at Elland Road. Oh, God, I hope that the title race continues to go on. This could be one of the most dramatic ends to a save, let alone a season, ever. It would, if we win the Premier League this season, it would be up there with the Jamie Shackleton moment of the Leeds United save. But for now, we're just going to take it one game at a time and see how far we can go. 3-0 with the second leg of the Champions League against Liverpool coming up after this one, where we should hopefully get ourselves through to the final of that competition. Again, Henderson's done well to tip that away as Leeds look to get themselves back in it. But if I'm brutally honest, they haven't been at the races here, Leeds, and it is going to be a comfortable victory. And we could even get Jack Rolls a hat-trick if that pass had gone where I wanted it to, which it hasn't. So I'm sorry, Jack, no hat-trick for you yet. Maybe still, though. Nope, no hat-trick for you yet. Maybe still, though. Offside. Sorry, Jack. No hat-trick. Quachiata. Out to Martinez-Losa. Quachiata again. Sanderberger out Muslim. Oh, what a turn. Pizzini through to Sorescu. He's onside looking for his teammate. Cano's in the way. Goal difference could be important again at the end of the season if we are to close the gap at the top. But oh, we're doing a good job here of being 3-0 up. We just need to make sure we don't concede. I am going to jinx myself at some point in this Leeds United game. 3-1. Jack's made a good run. I actually play the 1-2 with Priestiol. Now, can we get Jack a hat-trick? No! Oh, God, Jackie boy, come on. You've got to finish that. Stood up to him. Could have gone with his head. Decides to go with the acrobatic left-footed effort and misses the target. The chance of a Premier League hat-trick at Elland Road escapes Jack Rolls, unfortunately. But we will get a hat-trick of points. 3 coming our way. Abadia, Don Brown's on the run. Ah, slightly misplaced pass. Not to worry, we will get the win. And that's all we can do at the minute, is continue to win our games. We have Liverpool to play in the Champions League next. Then we have Liverpool to play in the Premier League tomorrow. Things get even more intense. On this particular match day, Liverpool beat Newcastle. Chelsea beat Norwich. They will continue to move away from us at the top of the table. And it is becoming more and more unlikely that we'll win the Premier League this season. But still have Liverpool to play. If we can beat them and Chelsea drop points, oh, it still could happen. The dream is still there. Right, Liverpool again. Again, we'll play with this team. I need to make the change to put the Metro in there permanently, don't I? With a 3-0 lead in the first leg, I mean, we're surely through. God, have I just jinxed myself. We're surely through. I'm going to stick with it. We're surely through. Time to take the trip to Anfield and get ourselves into the Champions League final. Liverpool's 11 does have a change in there with Joshua Vanneman at right back and Lucas Klostermann dropped to the bench. Chiarovella is in the midfield as well. And Salah on the right-hand side this time. 3 changes to the 11 that lost 3-0. We should still... I mean, even if we lose, I don't see Liverpool beating us by 3 goals or more. I think we've done the job in that first leg. And a man again. Ethan Clark comes away with it. I mean, one away goal. Just to make sure. One away goal just to make sure is what would be great. I mean, you might as well keep going, Pereira, because you're in. Baron Achea tackled by Virgil van Dijk. Maybe I should have just kept running with a right back. Wilson with a good header. Nemecha gets it as Ethan Clark hops over it. I'll lift this looking for the runner. Nemecha, who's found well, and will drill it across the box. And Brianson's there. What a goal! What a start at Anfield. That was superb. That was outrageously good. Oh, what a team goal. Lifted by Ethan Clark, chested down by Nemecha, driven across, and Brianson is there. Right place, right time again for the Frenchman, and buried first time. Liverpool need 5. Gabby again, here's Barella. Oh, what a ball through to Mo Salah. Wow, that was really good. Away by right, thankfully. Those long, rangy legs working wonders to ensure that we keep a clean sheet for the time being. Wilson does well to steal that away from Mo Salah, and I tell you what, there's some space on that right-hand side for Baron Achea. Quickly to Nemecha. He's going to have the legs on Van Dijk. Dink it looking. Oh, it was meant for Bissouma. Oh, still could find Bissouma. It has done. We've scored anyway. Not how I wanted to score, but we have. So the end result is what we wanted. And to be fair, I wanted Yves Bissouma to get the goal. So there you go. Yves Bissouma on the score sheet in the Champions League. Still having an impact for us after a couple of very good seasons in the first team for him. Why that went all the way to Briançon, I'm not sure. I must have just put too much power on it, but buried nicely. 2-0. Liverpool need 6. Magnaman gets the cross in, but we should win that. Prayer Rock does nicely. Wouldn't let me change player, so I'm going to have to not win it with... Oh, and they're in. Well, I mean, if he let me change player, he's offside. Was he? No, he's not. If he let me change player, then I might well have actually been able to close that down with Bissouma as it dropped free, but it wouldn't. And I had to... I just didn't get anywhere near it. It's well played by Liverpool. They've made the most of the opportunity. Is the comeback on? They need 5 more goals, and there's 3 minutes to be played. Yeah, sorry, Liverpool. Consolation goal, just as was Leeds United. And you never know, we might score another anyway. Pereira Rock to deliver towards the back post. Cleared away. So they do get one, Liverpool. I'm not sure, actually, who's in the other semi-final. So I don't know who we're going to have. I think City are still in the competition. We've got Manchester City in the FA Cup final, and we had City in the Champions League final last season, didn't we? And beat them, obviously. Foul. No, just the final whistle. So we're through to the Champions League final. We're replicating last year so far in the Cups by getting to the final of the Champions League. Wow. The only shots in the game were the goals. Bloody hell. So we're through to the Champions League final again. Oh, no. It was a Milan derby in the other semi. We will play Inter Milan. Inter Milan in the Champions League final at the end of the season. And in the Premier League, they keep winning. They keep winning. We are 8 points from top. And, not happening, is it really? 8 points from top with 9 points available. It's just, I'm going to give up on it. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen, boys. There's no point filming a full episode tomorrow where it's just going to be pointless. As we found it, the situation last season, it would be just a pointless episode for me to record for you, and would just it'd be making a video for the sake of making a video to fill a day, which is pointless. We're not going to win the Premier League this season, I'm afraid, lads. It's not going to happen. So we'll simulate the remaining 3 games today, and then tomorrow you'll have 2 videos. One being an FA Cup final against Manchester City. The other being a Champions League final against Inter Milan. Let's see, might potentially win against Liverpool here away from home. Chat Rolls has given us the lead after Martinelli equalised. Post Liverpool going 1-0 up through Karamoko Dembele. Rolls has scored again and it's 3-1. So you would say that is Liverpool now definitely, definitively not winning the league. Chelsea go up to 90 points. They're out of reach of us. We mathematically now cannot win the league, and that's exactly why I decided to sim these games the way that we have, because it just was really intriguing when it was just 5 points with still a number of games to go. But as Chelsea and Manchester United have continued to win their games, unfortunately it's just stayed that little bit too far away from us. A quick fire double from Abadia and Martinelli, and then Campos following up with a third not long after to give us a convincing and resounding victory as Martinelli scores his second and now 4th in the first half. We're going to get a big win against Burnley. Sorry, lads. I'm not sure if... Oh, Abadia gets his second. No, Abadia's got a hat-trick. 6-0. Abadia has a hat-trick. Perez Siol, 7-0. Oh, Burnley, that's not gone well, has it, lads? Jeez, Louise. Sorry about that. Burnley, oh, they're going to survive. So at the bottom, Crystal Palace are relegated. West Ham still can stay up. It's going to be 2 of West Ham, Leeds, Brighton, and potentially Newcastle, as their goal difference is worse than Brighton's. Ah, no, because Leeds' is just awful. Okay, so 2 of West Ham, Leeds, or Brighton to get relegated. The Premier League title is between Chelsea, Liverpool, and Man United, although... Well, I mean, if Chelsea lose and Manchester United can get a good... Oh, my God. Man United have Liverpool. On the right-hand side, Man United have Liverpool. Chelsea have Crystal Palace. Who bought Chelsea have won the league. I don't think there's any way that Chelsea lose to Palace and Liverpool and Man United could draw and not even make it to 90 points as it is. Oh, dearie me. Right, well, I will just finish this Premier League season then whilst we're still in this highlight. We'll have a quick train, which we're doing now, and then we'll head to that final game of the season against Leicester, simulate that, and we will finish in fourth place in the Premier League this season, which is, well, actually, we could finish higher. With the two above us playing each other, what's goal difference? Ours was nowhere near theirs, was it? 50. Oof. If they draw, we could finish above Manchester United. If Liverpool win and we win, we'll finish above Manchester United. So we could still finish third and end up with our genuine best league position of the whole season. They lost recently to Everton. 6-0 they beat Wolves, though. Leicester. Man City take a 1-0 lead against Newcastle. They're not going to catch us from behind. Chelsea take a 1-0 lead, as you would have expected them to, against bottom of the league, already relegated Crystal Palace. It's now 3-0 to them. We've gone 1-0 up here. Still not. Oh, Man United went 1-0 up. I just saw that at the bottom before it disappeared. And Martinelli makes it 2-0 for us. Manchester United win 2-0, or are winning 2-0 against Liverpool. Vallejo brings it back. It's not over yet. Chelsea 6-0 winners. Bakayoko sent off for them. And I think that's Chelsea winning the league with us. Oh, Manchester United won. So I think we still finished fourth, haven't we? No, we have pipped Liverpool to third. We have pipped Liverpool to third on 88 points. Chelsea win the league. Manchester United second. Cambridge United third. And the highest league position we have of the entire save. Liverpool fourth. Manchester City fifth. Relegated were Crystal Palace, West Ham and Brighton, and Leeds survive on the final day and Brighton go down. Scenes at Elland Road after we beat them. They draw with Watford and stay up. Congratulations, Leeds United. You will be a Premier League side for the next season. Not that we're going to have the next season. Bradley Williams has broken his foot. And that will bring the Premier League season to a close. Thank you very much for watching, boys. I will join you tomorrow for a double header. With it being midweek, I probably won't premiere them because the majority of you will be at school or work. So I won't premiere them, but they will go up at midday and 3 o'clock. 12 o'clock for the FA Cup final, 3 o'clock for the Champions League final. I will see you in those two videos with the suits back on, of course, tomorrow.